your nice warm bed. You just remember what your old past said, or you got a friend in me.
Good morning, Gallup Hill School.
Would everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Would everyone please remain standing for a moment of silence?
Good morning, Colonel. Would everyone please raise their right hand and repeat the BARC pledge with us? I promise to be accepting, responsible, and kind. Everyone may now be seated.
It's now time for a morning announcement.
The final Monday in May is Memorial Day. It is a day to honor soldiers who died in war while serving in the United States military. Before it had the name we know today, Memorial Day was first known as Decoration Day. After the Civil War, people decorated soldiers' graves with flowers and flags so that they would not be forgotten. Civil War General John Logan issued an order. Decorating the graves was so important, he declared Decoration Day should be celebrated every spring. The first official Decoration Day took place at Arlington National Cemetery on May 30, 1868. There, 5,000 people gathered to decorate the gravestones of 20,000 Union and Confederate Civil War soldiers. After World War II, Decoration Day became known as Memorial Day, and in 1971 became a federal holiday. Each Memorial Day at 3 p.m., citizens are asked to observe a national moment of remembrance, a time of silent reflection to pay tribute to those men and women who have died fighting for the freedoms that Americans enjoy. Today, many people still decorate graves of fallen soldiers. Some also have family gatherings and watch parades. Who do you honor on Memorial Day?
That's all for our program today. Thanks for listening.
Thanks, everyone. Have a great day. Bye!